Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. It's been a while. For those of you new to the channel, welcome. Make sure you hit those like and subscribe buttons down there for us. That would really help us out. For those of you that have been with us for a while, we're doing something a little different than you're used to seeing on this channel. To this point, we've exclusively released bow hunting content. Now September through early January, that's not going to change. We still plan to publish a full season of bow hunting content. However, we are every bit as passionate when it comes to competing in tournament bass fishing as we are about bow hunting. The only reason we haven't released more fishing content is due to the commitment and all the time it takes to put out on the water to dial in and discover these very specific areas that'll seasonally hold big fish. Now, unlike a big Sam Rayburn or Toledo Bend Reservoir, our home lake is fairly small and it's developed along a high percentage of the shoreline, which makes most of the spots that we fish easily identifiable. For the most part, we have a great group of local fishermen. However, as is the case on most lakes, one of the quickest ways to ruin a great fishing spot is to tell other folks about it. So instead of posting absolutely absurd looking stuff like this, which is a fish over 8 pounds, that we caught earlier the same day, and she's already inside our live well at the time we're trying to catch this 10 pounder. We only want to post high quality content that's visually enjoyable and not stuff like that. So, I found this fish in practice the day before the tournament, but it was not yet locked on a bed and it wasn't ready to be caught yet. It was just hanging out in an area that was about 15 feet wide. It was roaming back and forth between three separate fanned out bed areas. When I first laid eyes on this fish, I estimated she was between 7 to 10 pounds, which is definitely a trophy size bass. However, I really felt as though odds would be super slim on that fish, one, being there on the next day, and two, being ready to bite on tournament day 20 hours later. So we made the decision to start this tournament by heading in the opposite direction, which was 8 miles away on the opposite end of the lake, where we'd already established a couple specific stretches that I knew we could get several decent bites to possibly fill our 5 fish limit. We took about 2.5 hours on the south end of the lake and managed to successfully fill our limit. Plus, we caught that 8.17 pound kicker in the first hour as well. So we really put ourselves in a good position early to take some chances and try to catch another giant and have ourselves a mega sack and a shot at the tournament win. Now let's get right into what you clicked here on this video to see. This 10 pound bass was set up on the transition of two types of aquatic vegetation, coontail moss and pondweed. Twice in the past couple weeks, I've already had pondweed wrap around my trolling motor shaft and it completely stopped the rotation of my trolling motor prop to make it inoperable until I pulled up the motor and removed the strands of pondweed. Point being, I knew this was going to be a battle to get this fish in the boat if she bit in this type of vegetation. I made sure that my rod, my line, and hook were all top of the line to give me the best chance of success possible. I used my power tackle rod, V1, extra heavy, paired with 55 pound samurai braid and an owner 4-aught wide gap hook. If you haven't tried out a power tackle rod, then you should. I'll put all the tackle and info for my gear in the YouTube video description below this, as well as the links. So make sure you use promo code JSLOT10 to save 10% on your power tackle rods. It took me 35 to 40 minutes to finally get this fish to bite on tournament day. When she did, that sound you hear is not my reel. It's the sound of a 10 pound bass making 55 pound braided line sing on a power tackle rod wrapped up in this vegetation. Without further delay, let's get right into the fish catch.
Go for it. Look at that, look at that. Told you I was going back to get it.
Great call yesterday. Why don't you use Braid? We got a mega sack.
Christmas tree.
We are about to cull a 295, number four, with this. Thank you.